family and friends. I call upon our present to be here and be fellow witnesses with me in the marriage of Pamela and Robert. We are here to wish them well and every happiness for their future life together. Pamela and Robert, marriage is founded upon sincerity and understanding, which leads to tolerance, confidence, and love. It involves respect for each other's feelings, weaknesses, and pride. We believe that those qualities which are attracted to each other best to deliver the right spirit. A happy marriage will enable you to establish a home, love, and stability. For your family and your friends will always be welcome, and which will be a base of the influence of your shared and recovery life today may extend. Every day that you live, learn how to receive love with as much understanding as you can give it. Find things within yourselves, and you can share them with one another. Do not fear this love. Have an open heart and a sincere mind. Be interested in each other's happiness. Be constant and consistent with your love. From this comes security and strength. All that we love deeply becomes a part of us on this day of your marriage. Try to commit yourselves fully and freely. The Bible has given us what may be the world's best definition of what it means to love. I'd like to share with you both a well-known passage from 1 Corinthians 13.
Congratulations!
And offered as a new model for the new life, which we are both created to love. Love is patient, and love is kind. It is never jealous. Love is never false or conceited. It is never rude. It is never selfish. Love does not take offense, and it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's faults. It will delight in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, trust, and hope. It is always ready to endure whatever happens. True love is not complicated. But Pamela and Robert, love is the reason why this day was chosen by you both to begin this life together. Love is the reason why you both will give with all the hearts for the good of each other. Love is the reason that together you will become one. One in hope, one in believing in life, sharing the coming. Before you are joined in marriage, I am to remind you of the solemn and enduring nature of the relationship that both are about to have. Do you, Robert, take Pamela, your lawful wedded wife, from this day forward, to have and to hold, forsaking all others, for better and for worse, for richer and poorer, in sickness and in health, in love and cherishment, for as long as you wish shall live. Pamela, will you take Robert to be along when it was born? From this day forward, to have and to hold, forsaking all others, for better and for worse, for richer and poorer, sickness and in health, to love and cherish him for as long as you both shall live. And now I ask that God bless these rings, that Pamela and Robert will exchange as a symbol of their love and fidelity. May these rings be blessed as a symbol of this affection. These two lives are now joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, may they always return to one another in their together. May you two find in each other the love for which all men can be given. May both grow in understanding and compassion for one another. May the home that you establish together be a place of sanctuary, and many there will find a friend. And may these rings on your fingers symbolize a touch of spirit of love to have for each other in your hearts. Robert, will you please take them?
Take it and wear it as a pledge of my love.
Take it and wear it as a pledge of my love.
our body, and as a symbol of all we share, and as a symbol of all we share. Of this holy purpose and the power of this occasion, let us bless this union. Dear Father in heaven, as we come before your throne, we're offering this love. We ask that you bless this union. We pray that you will be the third strand that binds them together and cannot be broken. May you be the guiding light shining on this chosen path of life on the future. Family and Robin, as you begin this married life together, hold closely the words that you will speak to each other today. This life isn't always an easy road, as you both know. So rely on your faith and the promises you have made here today to help you through those times. Ask God to grant you the gifts of caring and understanding your life together, allowing that each may be to the other a source of strength and need, a counselor in times of uncertainty, a comfort in times of sorrow, and a companion of all of your joys. You have prepared for us all that you will live together in marriage. You have made special promises to each other, which have been symbolized by doing that, taking a vow, beginning a season of marriage. The authority vested in me by the state of Texas, I now declare you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride, sir.
Let me go ahead and get that license signed up for you.